Before I start the video, I wanted to point out that the screen might look a little different. Specifically, the text boundaries here, we've got these corner boundaries instead, and we can still turn them on and off as we did before. Another thing we'll notice is right above this text boundaries, putting your cursor here allows us to add a header. We can also add and remove it with the insert as seen in previous tutorials. To see what version you're working with, go into Help, About LibreOffice, and you'll see that I have 3.5.0. And one other thing I'll point out here is before I could successfully install 3.5.0, I needed to go into my control panel and uninstall my previous release. To show how the tabs work, we're going to turn on our ruler by going into View, Ruler, and we also want to turn on our non-printing characters. Now, remember on a ruler that we can change this from inch to centimeter on the horizontal as well as the vertical, and they are independent. I'm going to leave mine with inches. If I just hit the tab, it shows that I go over about a half an inch. And every half inch up here, we see our default tabs. To tab backwards, we would hit the backspace, removing our tabs. To take more control over our tab placement, we're going to use this little box in the left-hand corner. We've got four little shapes that it can turn to if we click on that shape. We've got our left justified tab, our right justified tab, our decimal point tab, and our center tab. To show how these work, I'm going to place a left tab between the 1 and the 2 here, just by clicking on it. And we notice our defaults all before our left tab have disappeared. Tabbing over, I'll type something in. And we see our tab symbol with our non-printing character. Let's go down to the next line, and I'm going to place a center tab around the 3. And to place it, I just click on the ruler at the bottom. I'm tabbing over. I tab past my left tab into my center. And it shows the text centered under this tab, whereas our first one is left justified. Clicking on the next one, I'm going to add a right tab over at the 6. So I'm tabbing past the left, past the center, and it's going to line up on the right. It's at this time I want to point out that our tabs carry forward but not up in the document. Clicking on the right tab, we see that we have all three tabs. If I go up a line, we notice that our right tab is no longer available, but we have our defaults. And going up one more, we only have our left tab. So if you want that tab to apply to the entire document, you might want to do a Control A and select the entire document and then place in your tabs, and it will carry them forward the entire time. There is one more tab symbol, the centering with the decimal, and I'll place one here about 4.5. Tabbing over to it, it lines up the decimal point in numbers. Sometimes lining up decimal points in text documents can be very difficult, especially if you've got multiple fonts or sizes. That decimal point tab can come in very handy. Now that we have our tabs out there, we also want to know how to remove them. To remove a tab, we would click on the line that we want to remove the tab from and just drag it off the ruler, and the tab is gone. Remember that the tab key is part of the paragraph formatting. Every time I hit the end of paragraph, after the left tab, after the center, after the right tab, it started a new paragraph formatting. So that's why we have 5 lines and 5 different paragraph formattings. A better way for me to have done this would have been tab, holding down Shift Enter means new line. Now I'm tabbing over to the center. Tab. Holding down Shift Enter. Tab, tab. One more to get to that right. Right, tab. Shift Enter. Now we can see the difference while showing our non-printing characters. A end of paragraph and a new line. They look a lot different there. Turning off the non-printing characters, they look the same. But here, to change or move a tab, we just select the whole thing. I can move my right tab in a little bit. Right back out. And there's no problems.